KitchenSix podcast. This is episode 16. I'm your hostess, Nellie, and it's been, 2 months? Yeah, 2 months since I last recorded an episode. December, my husband took 3 weeks off, and we just kind of chilled, and I didn't feel like taking away from that time. And then when he went back to work, my kids were still home, so we just sort of enjoyed the whole month just chilling and relaxing, and it was amazing. It was probably one of the best months we've had in a long time. It's been 2 months. January just exploded. Yeah, we'll get into that later. There's chatter at the end. We'll do that. So welcome back if you are somebody that's already watched my podcast before, and if you're new, thanks for joining us. I hope you stick around. It's okay if you don't. There's so many podcasts out there, and everybody has their own tastes. I know I do, and I know that many others do, so feel free to choose one of those if this one's not your thing. I won't be offended. But know that I love you, and I'm glad that you're here today anyway. Yeah. So, happy Christmas. Like a month late. It was a really nice Christmas around here. We really had a lovely, quiet Christmas, and it was really, really nice. Sorry, I need some coffee. This is my favorite mug. And I've shown you guys this before. I don't keep lots of mugs in the house. In fact, I got another mug for Christmas, and now I have to go through and unmug a mug because I have too many mugs. I try to keep things to a minimum so that I don't have to keep making space for new things. So where was I? Oh, I'm totally distracted today, guys. I'm sorry. Christmas. Christmas was lovely and quiet and beautiful, and we stayed home, and we had just a simple, quiet Christmas with our kids, and it's not something we do very often. Usually we're traveling and doing all kinds of crazy stuff at Christmas, so it was nice to just take a year off of that. The kids kind of missed going everywhere and doing everything with everybody, but I think everybody was happy just to chill and relax. So yeah, and then we had, then school started again. And that's been crazy. Yeah. So, I hope you had a really lovely Christmas, and I hope that your new year is going as well as it can be expected to go. I know many of us are afraid of what's going to happen. But I have hope. I have hope that things will get better, and that if they don't get better, people will make better choices in the future. So, yeah, that's all I'm gonna say. So moving on, let's go into that just happened. Look what I'm wearing. This is my Hidofude, and it literally goes down to mid-thigh in the back. Like, I don't have enough space here to show you all that it is, but it is gorgeous. And I like it closed like this, so I think I'm gonna have to get a brooch or something. I'm just using one of my safety pins, or my safety pin movement safety pins. But I really like the way that it fits like that. And I think once we remove the other breast, which is a thing we'll talk about later, it will fit exactly like I want it to. But it's beautiful. Excuse me, I had to get comfortable again. It's beautiful, and it's comfortable, and it's soft, and it's cozy, and I'm totally just rubbing on the microphone, sorry. I love it. It's beautiful. I'm so happy with it. I think once I get my body shape fixed, it will fit a lot better, and I will be completely happy with it. Yay! But I finished this in December, I think. Yeah. Or maybe early January. I don't know. When I knit, when I could knit and when I was up to knitting, I knit on this and a couple of other things that I was finishing. And I put it on a, when I blocked it, which, it did a really great job of blocking it, I think. I wrapped a towel around a wrapping paper roll, like a sturdy one, wrapped a towel around that, and then safety pinned the towel and the roll to a hanger. And I slipped the sleeves over the roll like this and just let it hang block. It dried really fast and it stretched it out nicely so that you could see the lace pattern, and gave it a good amount of length, which is what I was really going for, I think. So that looked really cool. There's pictures of how I blocked it on Instagram if you want to go look. I will put a couple of pictures of me wearing it in here as well. And you can see the whole, it's gorgeous, you guys. The color didn't turn out as well as I hoped at the bottom, but I think it looks like a slight fading or ombre effect. It's it looks fine. And I don't care. It's gorgeous and I love it and I'm just gonna wear it anyway. So that's my hitofure. That's one of the things that happened. The other things that happened, I made like a bunch of hats. So I remember I told you guys that I was making cancer hats. So I made two that I sent off to a cancer patient in Portland who's been doing chemo for a while and she needed more hats. So I sent some to them. And then the awesome and amazing Ellie of Artistic Lily sent me three skeins of yarn to turn into hats, and I made beautiful hats with those. The pictures are on Instagram. I'll see if I can put some in here. But the leftovers that I have from that are, because I made a small to medium women's hat with this one, and I made a medium to large women's hat with this one. You can see the difference. And then I made a giant man hat with the little boy blue colorway, which this is like the tiniest ball of yarn left. So there's like, I don't know, maybe 4 yards of yarn left. So I used almost all of it. And I made this giant ribbed fisherman's type with the fold over brim hat. It'll fit the biggest heads, so it's a giant man hat. And it was so, super soft, and my husband was like, where's that one going? I was like, you can't have this one. This one's donated yarn and donated, it's going to the hospital. And he was like, but I like it. I made those three, and then, and those other two that I showed you, and then I made this one out of scraps that I had. But when I finished this one, my husband was like, so what are you doing with that one? I was like, I was gonna donate to the hospital. And he was like, why you gotta donate to the hospital? It's like, really, dude? So my husband claimed this hat, so I am going to knit another one. Or more. I went back to the hospital again this week and the hat bin was empty again. And we're expecting more cold weather. So I will be probably knitting some more hats out of the softest stuff that I have in my stash. And hopefully that will help keep somebody's winter warmer. Because, yeah. So the other thing that I finished was the hat that I had started for me. I did put a stripe of this really pretty sherbet-y colored yarn, and I love the way that it pooled because it pooled in chunks. So it looks like, yeah. And I did the pretty spiral decreases on the top that I like so much. And it's, I would put it on, but I would mess up my hair, and that's a whole thing. We've done this before. But it fits really nice, and it's cozy, and it's just a little bit loose, which I really like. It's nice and warm, too, and I like it a lot. So, I think that's all the hats. I think it is. For now. I'm gonna make more this month because it's still cold and there's still people that need hats, so I'm gonna do that. What else today? Oh, my daughter's Seabrook cardigan. I don't remember if I showed you this finished last time or not. I think I finished it in December, which means that you would not have seen it finished. But I knit two little barely there sleeves on this thing and the hood, and so basically it's just a great big schlanket with a hood and a couple of little sleeves. It's in seed stitch. I am never going to knit another full garment in seed stitch again. I hate seed stitch. I mean, every now and then for like a border maybe, but not the full garment. It was tedious. It was really tedious, and I got very bored with it, and I didn't like the way that it felt while I was knitting it, and it just, eh. But my daughter loves it, and she's worn it to school several times already. And she saw that there was yarn left over, and she was like, ooh, can I have a neck warmer? So I knit her a neck warmer. I started with this one. This is how she said she wanted it, and I don't like it. I didn't like it while I was knitting it. I didn't like it once I finished it. So I finished it and bound it off and I gave it to her and she was like, thank you. And I said, I don't like it. And she said, why not? I said, I just don't like it. So I knit her another one. And this one I like much better. It's I ribbed the edges. It's basically just the same thing, only the fabric's not quite so tightly knit. And I did ribbing at the bottom and the top, and yeah, it's a little bit shorter and less wide, or maybe a little bit wider, but I think overall it looks nicer on her and it's easier to wear. So either way, she has two now, so yeah. I also knit. And I don't have them here to show you because my son is wearing them. I knit him a sweater and a cowl that match. The sweater is the child's shawl collar pullover, and I'll put the information here about the designer and stuff. But I knit it out of a blue-green and heathered gray-blue acrylic that he picked out. It's in my last podcast if you want to see the yarn. I don't have a sample of it with me. I think I tossed whatever was left. I really wasn't up to dealing with it anymore. But I finished that, like I just finished weaving in the ends Thursday or Friday. And handed it to him Saturday to put in with his laundry because it's acrylic, so that's honestly. So he washed it with his stuff, and when it came out of the dryer, he put it on, and he was literally worn it Saturday, Sunday, Monday. Skipped Tuesday, wore it Wednesday, and he's wearing it today. So, yeah. I was going to ask him to leave it, but he looked so cozy when he put it all on this morning. He was like, I'm not even going to wear a jacket. I'll be fine in just this. So, yeah.
And that's all I've completed, which I know is a lot, but it's been 2 months, so yeah. I didn't complete them all at once. It was over the last 2 months that I've completed all of them. And a lot of the things I knit monogamously on until I finished them, because that's not something that I'm good at doing and I'm trying to be better at it. I have been known to have multiple projects going and nothing finished, which I don't think is how I want to do it. So I've been working on being monogamous when I want something done. And that's been getting things done, which is nice. So yeah, with that, we will move on to doing it and doing it and doing it well, which is, there's only a couple of things because I finished most of the random projects that were around. I am making a big squishy cancer hat. This is a really thick, it's a chunky acrylic, but it's a softer one, and I know for a fact that it softens up even a little more after you wash it. So, and I've got 3 different colors of this yarn and like 4 different balls. So, I can make some stripies and I can make several different sizes, and it'll go really quickly because it's nice big chunky yarn, and they'll be really warm because it's supposed to snow again, which isn't awesome. But so I'm knitting these on a size 10, which is a 6 millimeter on a 16-inch cable, and it's just loops and threads, which I think is the Michaels brand of yarn. But it's not super scratchy. It's actually fairly soft. I could have worn this. So, but that's that. That should be done in a couple of days probably, because I think that's my to-go project for now. And then I also have my husband's sock, which I restarted. I know, I said I was gonna just leave it, and I totally couldn't do it, you guys. I couldn't do it. I am such a perfectionist about my knitting sometimes. And I really am trying to let go of that, but it's difficult. The struggle is real, y'all. It's real. So, I have done the heel turn. So I did 80 rows of ribbing for the cuff and leg, because that's what he said he wanted. And then I did the heel turn. And it's just a slip stitch heel, but I carried it and I'm carrying it all the way down under the heel of his foot so that it's nice and durable. and I'm working on the gussets right now. And I'm gonna do ribbing on the top of the foot so that even if it's a little big, it'll still fit really well. Because this is my first sock for him, so I have no idea what's gonna work for him. So we're just kind of hoping it. And it's just, yeah. So, but that's that, and that's the one. And I am hoping to get this done within the week. Well, not this week. The next week, because there's only a day left of this week. So, but that's in Cascade. I don't remember the colorway, but it's just their sock yarn, and it's a charcoaly gray color, and it's really nice and soft and cozy. But yeah, so I'll do that one, and then I'll. It's not even a pattern anymore. It's just what I've done. It's just kind of what I did on my socks, and I'm doing it on socks for him. So that's coming along nicely, and he's very excited about them, which I'm excited for. He keeps asking about my knitting. Is that for me? He's ridiculous. The other thing, and I started this yesterday, so this is sort of shiny, pretty things, and doing it and doing it well. Started this yesterday. This is a shawl. It's called the Flotus shawl, and it's by Shannon Squire. She did hers in gradients with a contrasting yarn. I'm not doing mine in gradients. I'm just doing it in 2 colors, but I think it's gonna look just fine. So, color one is this beautifulness. It's Malabrigo sock and it's called Lettuce. Oh my gosh, you guys, this green. This green. Yeah. So pretty, super pretty, and I felt like it was calling the name of somebody that I wanted to knit something for. And then I'm not gonna say who. So there. And then I got this as the contrasting color, which is, it's coming up just a little muted, but together they look really, really nice. And the difference is going to be really subtle. So I cast it on, I literally cast it on in the yarn store after she wound up the yarn for me. And I've got through the first color change. And I really like the way that it's coming out. It's so pretty, you guys. And I posted a picture on Instagram, but I couldn't get the color to come out right because it was dark. But that is really how it's looking. I love the way that it looks. And the fabric feel is, it's nice. I'm really loving this project. I did not want to put it down last night when I had to go to bed. And I really just wanted to pick it up this morning, but I was like, I have to make a podcast. So I got all the stuff ready for the podcast instead of knitting on this when I wanted to this morning. So I'm hoping to get that done. I'm probably just going to knit on that this weekend, and hopefully it'll be done in a matter of a couple of days because I really, really enjoyed knitting on it last night. I didn't think I was going to. I thought... since the yarn is such a fine yarn, and I'm still having troubles with my hands this winter, I thought it was going to be a struggle to keep doing it, but it's not. It's beautiful, and I love it, and I love the way that it's coming out. It makes me happy. So, but that's also Sash Enhancement. Those are both Malabrigo sock. This one is called Primavera. And it matches the lettuce really nicely. I'm knitting that on size 5s, which I can't remember I think it's 3.25. Not sure. You probably should check that. But yeah, so I ordered a second set of size 5 tips because there's another project that I want to do that's going to be on size 5s, and we'll talk about that in What's Cooking. So, but yeah, so... I'm going to have to move that to a longer cable tomorrow when the tips and cable come in that I ordered. So yeah, so moving on to, I just blanked. Oh, shiny pretty things. Moving on to shiny pretty things. I got very little knitting things for Christmas, but I did get a gift certificate for Etsy. I know, right? And it was really difficult to choose things, but I finally decided on the Galaxy colorway from Bad Wolf Girl Knits, or Bad Wolf Girl Studios, and it's really that sparkly, you guys, and it's so, so, so pretty. So, who is making those socks? The Sisters podcast. I can't remember the name of their podcast. Why can't I remember the name of their podcast? I'll put it right here. But one of the sisters is making police box socks, like Doctor Who police box socks, out of this Galaxy yarn. And, they're amazing. I want them. I want them so badly. I just can't even. Yeah. That's all grocery girls. You're welcome. So since I had the gift certificate, I ordered two of them so that I can have one for later, maybe a shawl for me, and then one for the socks because, oh my gosh, those socks are so cool. Yeah. So, I've got those, and I'm in love with them, and they came, she sent this tea, I don't know if it's still available, I'm gonna have to find some, It's amazing, you guys. It's so good. I loved this tea. It was delicious, and I'm gonna have to go look and see if there's any left because, yeah, really good. Maybe I can order it off Amazon. Amazon will have it, won't they? Oh, Okay. So, and then while I was at the yarn store looking at yarn for specifically for the Flotis shawl, this kind of accidentally fell into the bag too. You guys, it's so green. Look at how green it is. It's called apple green, which I am in love with this color. It's showing up a little mintier than it really is. I am hoping that you're gonna, but it's like really just like a sassy apple acid green. It's gorgeous. But it's Rios, so it's like a worsted. It's really I have no idea what I'm gonna do with it, but I couldn't leave it there. It was all by itself. It was really lonely. It needed friends, so I brought it home where it can be friends with all of the things. So, yeah. That one. Sorry about the squeaking. That was weird. My bad. Yeah. That's all of the shiny, pretty things. Oh, that's not true. I'm a liar. I'm a liar, you guys. I got a book too. Hold on, let me reach for it. Eey. You see all the pattern? Isn't it gorgeous? Okay, so I got Jane Austen knits, and it's got some cute things in here that I know that my mom and my sisters and a friend or two of mine will love. So, and that's why I got it. There's this really cute jacket that I know that my mom will love. And there's this front one I know that my friend will love. So, and there's a couple of other patterns in there that I really like, and there's one that I'm contemplating making for my husband. Yeah, so that's that. That's all the shiny, pretty things. Oh, no, that's not. I'm a liar. My husband did get me one thing. I don't know if you can see it through the glare. It's really sunny out right now. But it says, "What up, my knittas?" I love it. Gonna use it on knit night and drink my wine out of it. So yeah, that's that. And then we have, oh, what's cooking? I have to turn the page because I'm going to run out of space. What's cooking? Oh, tonight we're having teriyaki chicken, which is going in the crock pot because we are doing martial arts on Tuesdays and Thursdays. So on Thursdays, I'm not here to cook dinner, so I put dinner in the crock pot, which has been, it's been working pretty well. So today it's going to be teriyaki, which is just like six or eight chicken thighs, boneless, skinless chicken thighs. I just toss them in there. I cut up an onion, I toss that in there. I cut up two or three cloves of garlic, toss that in there. And then I put in about a cup, maybe 3/4 of a cup of soy sauce, about 3/4 of a cup of water, and then about a half a cup of, maybe that's a little much, maybe about a quarter cup of brown sugar. And then a tablespoon or two of cornstarch. You gotta mix the cornstarch in with the water so that it's like a slurry, and then add it. But that'll just thicken up the sauce enough so that it's not all goopy. And then let that sit all day, and then about an hour before you serve, maybe half an hour, not very long at all, put in some frozen sweet peas, and then serve over white rice. Really simple. My kids love it. My husband loves it. It's easy. Nobody complains, and dinner's fast and delicious. So, yeah, that's what's cooking. And then, for knitting wise, what's cooking? I'm going to make this cowl, but again, I'm not going to do the gradient colors like they've done here. And that's the Brush Creek Cowlet. It's by Karina Spencer. She's the same person that designed the Zuzu's petals, which I love the Zuzu's petals. But you remember last time I showed you this gorgeousness? It's called Purple Pop. It's by Jorstad Creek, which is a local yarn dyer to me. They dye here in Olympia. and it's silk. Well, it's merino, 75 merino and 25% mulberry silk, and it's really soft and really cozy, and I'm super, super excited to make it for somebody special who deserves something special right now. So I'm gonna start that as soon as I finish the FLOTUS shawl. I'm gonna start this, or maybe before. We'll see. I've been like dying to cast this on, and yeah, so I might just cast it on today. We'll see. Yeah, and then the other things that I'm doing, I think that's it that I have planned for now. I'm gonna finish my husband's socks, and then once those are done, the police box socks are the next thing that are coming up. I still have to get a couple of different yarn colors for that because there's a band in there that has some color work and stuff, so I need a white and I need like a dark blue, I guess, for that band. I don't know. I'll have to look at the pattern and order the pattern, and then yeah, this whole thing. So I told you that. Oh, we're moving on to chit chat now. All the yarny stuff is done. So if you don't want to look at anything that's not yarny, I'm done with the yarn. You guys can shut me off and have a wonderful, wonderful February, and I will probably see you around Valentine's Day. And big, squishy, lots of yarny hugs for you guys because I know we're all struggling right now. I get it. I'm there with you. It's a disaster, and we all hate it, and I'm so sorry. But hopefully things will get easier and things will settle down and it won't be as awful as it feels like it's going to be. So let's be hopeful and be patient and be kind. That's our thing. So love you guys if you're out here, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you around. If you're here for the chit chat, yeah. January exploded. My husband's injury is more serious than we thought. And he's been going through physical therapy and having to do MRIs and craziness. Yeah. And we're hoping that it doesn't end up in surgery. But if it gets any worse, it's almost guaranteed that he's going to have surgery. January is also the month when I go through and do a bunch of appointments for checkups to make sure that I am still cancer-free. And I'm still cancer-free, as far as I know. Nobody's called me, so I'm guessing that's good. It usually is. Usually they call right away if there's anything at all. They don't know what that spot is. Caller. Yeah. So, but I did all of that, and on top of all of my husband's appointments and my appointments, my son has been bullied at school for like over a year now. There was a blow up in September, and there was the hoopla about getting him in the right class in August, and then the initial finding out of what's going on last June. And then he was attacked. So I went full mama bear. And I lit into the principal, and I lit into, well, I did, I just lit into the principal knowing it's not her fault, but also knowing that my son was thrown to the ground and tripped repeatedly and humiliated by three boys who wouldn't let him get away. So he defended himself, and I made sure that he was not punished for that. I also made sure that the school was aware that this was an ongoing problem that I've discussed with them before, and they had a responsibility to keep him safe. So they are fulfilling their responsibility now. And while I don't blame the principal for what happened, I do blame her for not making sure that it didn't happen. So, and I let her know that politely, but angrily. Yeah. So, most of the parents are, one of the parents is definitely like, oh, that's not okay, and she's dealt with her child accordingly. The other parent is in complete denial that there's a problem, and yeah, that's been interesting. But we've put my son in martial arts, which is why Tuesdays and Thursdays are now crockpot days, because martial arts is at dinner time, and yeah. And because I live in the back of Beyond, it takes me half an hour to get there and half an hour to get back. So there's an hour of driving on top of an hour of martial arts. So there's no time, literally, no time for me to make dinner during the dinner hour. So we eat late on those days and it comes out of the crock pot. But yeah, January has been crazy. It's been insane. But I think we're getting it to some sort of oh, and wrestling. My daughter was in wrestling all of January, so there was all of that as well. There was wrestling. I have to pick her up from wrestling every day, at a totally different time than I have to pick up my son. And then it's been a little crazy. So yeah, that's why you didn't get a podcast in January. Between my appointments, my husband's appointments, my daughter's wrestling schedule, and my son's bullying issues at school, and the new schedule for martial arts, I haven't really had a chance to make time for it. So, but I think we've got it under control now, and I think we've got a steady schedule. We'll see how it goes when track starts. That should be interesting. But the other thing that's going on, at the end of March, I will be having a surgery to remove my other breast. Not because there's anything wrong with it. I'm fine. But after 4 surgeries to try to reconstruct the left side and have a matching set, and still not having any success, my options for reconstruction aren't awesome. And I'm done. I'm done. I think the easiest, safest, least painful, and most convenient way going forward is just no breasts at all. So that's what we're doing. And yes, my husband is okay with it. We've talked about it extensively. I think he just really wants me to be comfortable moving forward. So that's what we're doing. So yeah. It's been a crazy month. But I'm really looking forward to that happening, and I'm really looking forward to having it normal-ish and the same on both sides-ish. I'm not a perfectionist about that. I really don't care about the scars or if they're perky. I don't care. I just want to be able to put on a t-shirt and look normal and not weird and yeah. So it'll take some getting used to, but I think in the long run, it'll be better for me. So, I think that's all the chit-chat I have for you guys. I do have to get going because I have to take my friend who is sick to run her errands because she is really too sick to be doing them, but they need to get done because that's what we do as moms, yeah? Yeah, so I'm going to take her out and get her stuff done, and then I will be back to edit this hopefully tonight. Yay! After martial arts. It's a whole thing. Anyway, I love you guys. I hope that you are having as good of a January as you can have, and I hope that February brings you lots of love and joy and lots of knitting, because I think that's the only way we're all getting through, huh? Yeah. Love you guys. Bye.